God when he went forth before your people, marching with them and living among them. The earth trembled, heavens poured down rain. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us first call to mind our sins and ask the Father for his pardon and his mercy. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, who are Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who for the salvation of the world brought about the paschal sacrifice, be favorable to the supplications of your people, so that Christ, our high priest, interceding on our behalf, may by his likeness to ourselves bring us reconciliation, and by his equality with you free us from our sins. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the court officers had brought the apostles in and made them stand before the Sanhedrin, the high priest questioned them. We gave you strict orders, did we not, to stop teaching in that name? Yet you have filled Jerusalem with your teaching and want to bring this man's blood upon us. But Peter and the apostles said in reply, we must obey God rather than men. The God of our ancestors raised Jesus, though you had him killed by hanging him on a tree. God exalted him at his right hand as leader and savior, to grant Israel repentance and forgiveness of sins. We are witnesses of these things, as is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him. When they heard this, they became infuriated and wanted to put them to death. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial song. The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His mouth shall be praised ever in my mouth. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Blessed the man who takes refuge in him.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth. When the just cry out, the Lord hears them, and from all their distress, he rescues them.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit he saves. Many are the troubles of the just man, but out of them all the Lord delivers him.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
At this time, Jesus said to Nicodemus, the one who comes from above is above all, and the one who is of the earth is earthly and speaks of earthly things. But the one who comes from heaven is above all. He testifies to what he has seen and heard, but no one accepts his testimony. Whoever does accept his testimony certifies that God is trustworthy. For the one whom God sent speaks the words of God. He does not ration his gift of the Spirit. The Father loves the Son and has given everything over to him. Whoever believes in the Son has eternal life, but whoever disobeys the Son will not see life, but the wrath of God remains upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
People often ask over the last few weeks, as we've had a much quieter time, most people are staying home, Father, what do you miss? And I said, I miss Thursdays. Because Thursdays is when our parish would have the entire school community for Mass to see the students bring up the gifts and the beautiful choir and cantors sing and the altar servers and the ushers. It was a beautiful tradition that I hope we can get back on track very soon. So Mr. Elliott and members of the parish asked if we could make Thursday Masses on TV our school Mass. So I hope this morning I can greet many members of our school community, students and parents and faculty. To help give that appearance, we've actually asked for special guests to come and serve as lector of Mass. So Mrs. Hutchinson, our second grade teacher, good to have you with us. Thank you for being here. I hope second grade is proud of you reading today at Mass. And also, one of the things I love to do on Thursdays after Mass was visit the classrooms. Thursday was my teaching day at St. Ambrose. And one of the things I love to do would be to talk about the saints. And today, April 23rd, is the feast of a rather well-known saint, St. George. So to Mr. George Elliott, our principal, happy feast day, Mr. Elliott. Today is the day we pray for you and ask for the intercession of your patron saint. St. George was a Roman soldier living in the 200s, known as the 3rd century. It's there that he was on assignment to the Holy Land, somewhere around Israel or Syria. It was there that, although the Romans were pagans and did not know Christianity, he first heard the gospel. He was so moved by Jesus, and his heart was so open to Jesus, he was baptized and became a member of the church. However, it was illegal for Roman soldiers to do that. But yet he loved Jesus so much, nothing could stop him. And so he became not only a Christian, he became a practicing and devout Christian. He would take the money given to him, his salary, and share it with the poor and needy. When he saw the sick, he would help them. When he saw people unjustly put down, he would get off his horse and go over and put an end to the injustice. He was a man of incredible virtue and holiness. And at first, people thought he was just being kind. But then they realized there was something different about this military officer. His bravery, his words, his deeds, his virtue, his morals were so beautiful and affecting so many people. They thought something new and different with this man. What could it be? Eventually, he was denounced for being a Christian. And for that, he was arrested, and he was told to renounce the faith and be put to death. But George, a brave military soldier, was not scared of anything as long as he had Jesus and the promise of heaven. In fact, that's our gospel today. Jesus in the gospel today tells Nicodemus that those who believe in me keep their minds on the things of heaven, not the things of this world. And so it is that George died a martyr. Now, many years later, when the Holy Land was in a great battle going on, soldiers from Europe called the Crusades would come over in the 10 and 1100s to try and liberate the Holy Land. Many soldiers coming would hear stories of this holy soldier. And so the Crusaders adopted St. George as their patron saint. And so even to this day, soldiers and policemen and first responders all take St. George as their patron saint. And so they deduced a flag of St. George with a big X on it. And when the English knights returned back to England, and a few years later formed a nation, they took the flag of St. George and used that as the basis of what is known as the Union Jack, or the British flag. But St. George was the model intercessor to the Christian knights during the Crusades. And so stories were told of his faith, his holiness, his charity, his courage. There were even legends of him doing incredible acts of holiness or bravery, including one famous legend of him fighting a dragon. Sometimes you see pictures of St. George fighting a dragon. It was truly a story passed down to illustrate his great bravery and courage to always serve God, no matter what may happen. George and his bravery speak to all of us. No matter who we are, no matter what grade we're in or what our vocation is, God calls all of us to not be afraid, to live our faith, to love God, and to serve others. On this feast of St. George, may God bless all soldiers, policemen, and first responders who are so busy and do such incredible work today. May they truly protect us, keep us healthy, and keep us safe. May God also help all of us to grow in courage, that we too can be holy knights, strong in our faith, serving God and serving the church. St. George, martyr and soldier, pray for us. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, and human hands have made, become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, to become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
And the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all souls. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with these sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising to life, life has been risen to all. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Behold, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Hallelujah.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, restore us to eternal life. In the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our So grateful the members of our parish tune in every day to join us for Mass. Thank you so much. We are joined together at the altar at St. Ambrose, whether we are here physically in the church or we are watching from our office or home. In a special way, I thank all of our school community for joining us. I know that I hear from parents and teachers how good the students are getting their homework and their assignments done every day. I hope this Thursday Mass can be added to your usual routine these last few weeks of the semester. Please know to the parish and the school, you have a special place in our prayers. The priests and seminarians and faculty, we pray for you and your families every day. And again, tune in on Thursdays as we make this our school Mass, and we'll see what teacher will be our lector next Thursday. But we thank Mrs. Hutchinson for her bravery in the invitation of St. George today, the bravery to get up and do our readings. We look forward to see faculty on Thursdays doing that for our school Mass. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl throughout the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.